emotions are a complex thing. They are at the deepest level of our DNA. And the purpose of our feelings and emotions is to give us signals to make us conscious about the reality around us. So if you see a tiger, you feel scared and you start running away. That's important. Why? Because it keeps you alive. So this feeling gave you data about the nature of your reality, right? And it told you that there is danger. And based on that, then you can take action. In this case, sort of, you know, either fight the tiger or run away. So feelings are so important. But feelings also can be complicated. In fact, they are complicated because they operate at a very subconscious level. So by the time you're a grown up, you're an adult, you've already have piles and piles of unlimited, you know, data within your mind, you know, at a subconscious level. And feelings can be, you know, can come from so many different directions. It's just like emotions. You go to bed and then your dreams can take you to places, you know, next day you wake up and you're completely in shock and oh, where did this dream come from, you know, that completely strange dream. So it is the same complexity when we talk about feelings. Now, why am I saying this? I'm saying this so that I can highlight that we have to, you know, understand our feelings and use them as signals. That's number one. So every time you feel something, you have to ask yourself, okay, what are my feelings telling me? What is the data that is in my feeling? What's the nature of my feeling? You have to ask this question so that you can interpret where it's coming from and analyze what's happening, because it's a signal that talks about your reality or what's really going on in your mind, and then do something about it. Let's say I'm feeling sad. Okay, what am I feeling now? You examine, you ask yourself about your feeling and you give it a name. Am I feeling angry or sad? What is it? Okay, I'm feeling sad. Where is this sadness coming from? Then you start digging and you find the root of this feeling. And then you ask yourself, okay, what do I do with this? If you don't do this kind of examination, what happens? You will remain at a very shallow level, you know, totally controlled by your feeling that are taking you left, right and center without any control from your side. So you're sort of, you know, it's like you're on a small boat in the middle of the ocean and the winds are taking you in whatever direction they want. And that's not healthy. And some people, in fact, many people spend their entire life living this way. Now, there is a deeper level to this. And what's the deeper level? Is to understand and respect your feeling, but to make sure that, right, you are in control of your destiny, not your feeling. And how do you do that? By having clarity on what you want to do in your life. So when you have a clarity on what you want from life, real clarity, that's what I want from my life. That's what I want from my life professionally. That's what I want financially. That's what I want socially. That's the kind of family I want to have. That's the kind of friends I want to have. That's the kind of life that I want to live. Right? On all aspects. With whatever is humanly possible. As much clarity as possible. Right? And that's not an easy thing. But you have to have clarity on what you want from life. Then it's like driving. How can you drive if you don't know where you're going? You just, you know, whatever is any street that's open, you'll go there, but you'll get nowhere. So you have to have that kind of clarity. And when you have that kind of clarity, then that becomes your plan. So when you wake up in the morning, regardless of what you're feeling, right? Regardless of what you're feeling that come, you know, from your subconscious are telling you. You might feel horrible or in a very bad mood or not even, you know, you don't even have the energy because your feelings have consumed of this energy, all of this energy. You don't have the energy to get out of your bed. Or to, you know, to commit your plans or do your rituals, whether you want to, I don't know, have a shower or exercise or read or whatever it is that you want to do every morning and proceed into the day. So if you are dependent on your feelings, then I promise you, you will be tossed in all directions and most probably you'll waste your entire life. But when you have clarity on what you want to do, when you wake up in the morning, regardless of how you feel, you are guided by what you have to do. In short, do your duty as per what your strategy for your life, what your plan for your life, what you want from life requires. So that's the guiding principle. You don't check your feeling. How am I feeling today? I'm feeling great. Okay, then I jump from, you know, off bed, and I'm really enthusiastic and full of energy, you know, to capture the date. Or it might be that I'm feeling horrible, you know, or I'm feeling sad, or I don't know what's, you know, I have in a blue mood, or something is, you know, grabbing in my heart, or I feel like I'm in a dark, you know, under a dark cloud, whatever, and I'm going to stay at home. That will make things worse. You ask yourself, not what I'm feeling, you ask yourself, what is it that I have to do today to make sure that my day is a good day? That when I, you know, when I come back home, or when it's dark and I have to go to bed again, I look at my day and I say to myself, I did something productive. I moved forward. It doesn't matter if it's like 1 centimeter, 1 inch, you know, 1 meter, 1 mile. It doesn't matter as long as you're moving forward. Because they will, I mean, we're not computers. There will be one day that you will, you know, move forward, you know, 1 meter or 1 centimeter or even 1 millimeter. And there will be days that you will make quantum leaps, you know, that you will move miles in one day. At least you're moving. What matters is that you're not, you know, you're not stagnant, you're not stuck at the same place, you didn't waste a day without moving forward, or you didn't go backward. Because then you have to spend another day just to go back to where you were originally. So you're wasting double. So ask yourself, right, what is it that I have to do every day? What is my duty towards myself, towards my responsibilities, towards my family, my work, whatever it is? And focus on that regardless of how you feel. Now, is this nice? Absolutely, it is not nice. It is not nice. It's horrible, in fact, especially when you have to fight against negative emotions and negative feelings that are pulling you, you know, backward and asking you to stay and just get more depressed. But never do that, because negative feelings can spiral and become worse with time. Feelings are not static. So don't surrender to them. Encourage yourself, do whatever rituals you want to do. You can, I don't know, exercise, pray, meditate, listen to inspiring videos, speeches, read something inspiring, whatever it is. Find your own way that charges you with positive energy, right? And there's, you know, there are unlimited ways. Find whatever talks to you and do that mechanism so that you overcome your feeling and you focus on what you have to do. A day where you have not moved forward towards fulfilling your plans, doing what you have to do to live the life that you want to live, that you, that you want to live, is a wasted day. It's a crime against yourself. And how are you wasting it? You're wasting it in living a day that is horrible. So never be stuck with your feelings. If they're positive, you know, ride the wave and move forward full throttle to maximize the impact in moving forward towards the life that you are building, the life that you want to live. And trust me, it's not difficult, because the moment you start engaging in something constructive, your feelings will change, right? And what will happen? You will move into a positive feeling, and that will fill you with momentum and energy, and then you will start moving forward. Your life is about fulfilling your purpose, living the life that you want to live, and it's a very short one. You don't have time to be a hostage of feelings that can come from God knows what, you know, subconscious part of your life. You don't have time for that. You're guided by your purpose, your North Star, your own plan for the quality of life you want to live. Feelings have to work for you. You don't work for your feelings. You work for building the life that you deserve. That when you look at your life, you say to yourself, it's tough, but I'm living, I love my life. And by doing that, you inspire others as well. Follow your purpose, your North Star, make your feelings work for you.